Evening folks, this is BestInSlot and welcome back to our Planet Zoo campaign playthrough. The hope, the goal for today's video is to try to actually finish off our Brazilian quarry toxic waste foundation kind of thing, complete with a roller coaster, because that's just the kind of park we're building. So today's goal, we have to finish off silver first, but that means one habitat species, not a big deal. Then we're going to get ourselves a giant panda. So the first thing we need to do then is look at animal trading and pick what is our new animal going to be. What animal are we going to... I quite want a tapir, you know. I don't think I've had a bear's tapir in a super long time. Anything else tempting? Let's have a little squeaker through. Can I afford an elephant? Only one. Mandrills are a pain in the ass. I'm feeling the tapir. Tapirs are cute. And we'll also be getting a panda later on called Popo. I can't remember. Something like that. We don't really need those. Let's grab those. What's it called again? Nay? It begins with an N, doesn't it? It did tell me before, but now I've completely forgotten. Anyways. So, you're going to take your little tour ride around here, and it's going to drop you off over here, and we're going to put our panda in that corner, and we're going to put our tapir over there. So we'll just do like a little bit here, maybe a raised viewing platform, and that's hopefully going to... Huh. They've updated this. It's got a price on it now. Seems pointless, because they've all got prices on anyway, but that's okay. They're all the same price is what I mean. I guess some of the others are more expensive. No, they're all a dollar. Okay. So, let's go for... We should widen this up, shouldn't we, really? Let's go for a 7. 7 is my favourite, because 7 most closely reflects the, you know, the entrance to the park? The entrance to the park is a little bit odd, actually, because it doesn't perfectly match any of the sizes. It's a little bit bigger than a 7, a little bit smaller than an 8. But I found that 7 seems to be the best sort of middle ground. I'm going to do this a little bit differently than I had planned originally. I did want to make that raised as well, now that I think about it. I'm thinking we'll do the panda there, and then this path is going to curl around the back. Like so. Look how curvy we're getting. Sexy, sexy. And we're going to join that down here. Unfortunately, we do have to try to join it onto that bit, because, I'll tell you what, let's get a little funky with it. Why not? Live the dream. There you go. I like that. I don't know why. What's this? Dangerous animal has escaped. It's a baby ostrich. On no planet is that a dangerous animal. There is actually a mod out there for Planet Zoo that changes what animals are registered as dangerous for the sake of stuff like this, and also for the sake of, letting guests walk around with certain animals, so they'll be able to walk around with zebras and stuff like that and have like a African petting zoo. It's pretty cool. I was going to put trees down there. We shall do that in a bit. Excuse me. No, I'm dying. I want to get these tapirs into the park. We might try to do something a little bit fancy for the panda. Do we have... Do we have the Asian theme? Where are we? No, we should get that researching. I'm going to love... Oh, no. Everything's a disaster. Life is pain. Mariana, we're going to give you a little bit of an upgrade. Where's my staff? Marianne, I should say. Don't know why I'm calling her Mariana, but there we go. And we're going to have another mechanic, because we clearly need another one. And whilst all that's going on, we're going to build ourselves a tapir exhibit. I'm just going to pretend that everything's fine. I trust my staff to handle this job. Anyways. So, we've been using the corrugated plastic. Tell you what, we'll build it in glass first, and we'll go from there. How's that for a plan? BestInSlot, that's a great plan. Thank you, YouTube. You're very nice to me. So, we're going to keep the tapir fairly simple, and we'll try to do something a little bit fancier, I think, for the panda. So, let's just get this tapir into the park. Make it curvy. I've got a little bit shorter first. Come on. It's maybe not quite the shape I would have wanted, but there we go. This is going to be huge. I'm just realizing. I'm going to bring it in a little bit here. That can be like the staff section. We're just going to make this a weird shape. Weird shapes are cool. Snow leopard's breaking out and eating everyone. It's fine. Minor problems, folks. Minor problems. Oh my god, what is going on? Just everything has gone terribly right. Let's capture that. I guess that was before the boundary got fixed. The boundary doesn't seem to be fixed still. Mechanic is on route. I'm going to hire a couple more mechanics. Even if it's only a temporary measure, the boundaries are clearly a little bit of a problem. Let's get you shuffled over. Let's speed up time. Hopefully that'll... It's fine. That aardvark is currently being... Nope, that aardvark's down there. What about this aardvark? Also not being looked after. Good stuff. We do have a challenge to also make a certain amount of money a year, and at the moment we're kind of just hemorrhaging money, so I'm not sure how that's going to go. But, we'll guess we'll see. What's going on here? Why are you being weird? Oh, that's me being stupid. Habitat gate. Okay, not a problem. All we need to do is delete a little bit of the fence. I'm not going to explain how you do this, because I think I've done so about 20 times. Just going to join that onto there, join that onto there, join that onto there, and then... easy peasy! We will make this look a little sexier. I understand it is lacking in sexiness right now. I'm going to make all this into corrugated. I'm going to pretend the rest of the world's not an absolute disaster. And I don't know why, like, I don't love the corrugated, if I'm honest, but we've kind of committed to it now, so I think we have to lean into it, basically. We can't really change theme at this point, can we? Suddenly I've got cash coming in. Again, let's get these tapirs in. That'll help us out a little bit as well. People like animals. People, you know, nuts like that. What can I say? Actually, I'm making tons of money. I don't know what's going on. Maybe because we've got baby snow leopards, which is adorable. I'll put these on the middle, like so. I really wish there was a way to turn off the auto heat map. I love a bit of heat map, me, but sometimes it just makes it more difficult to see what's going on, basically. Like right now. Yee!
Ah, I see guest numbers are on the up. That's good. I'd hate for us not to have enough money to feed all those new animals you adopted. I mean, it's not like I can feed you to...
Lin!
No. Oh, and hey, that gondola ride looks pretty good. You had better not have gone over budget on it. Oh, I just remembered. Lin just arrived from the other zoo, so you'll need to find somewhere for her. This will be a nice holiday for her, but for complicated reasons which I won't go into, she's travelling incognito. So don't tell anyone it's actually Lin. Just make up some other name. But having a panda should really impress the inspector, So make sure nothing happens to her.
Gotta be honest, I was a little worried about that one, for that one to work out so easily, the inspection one that we just popped up there. I'm kind of surprised. What is going on with Lin then? Why is Lin so suspicious? I'm very curious right now. There you go. How are we feeling? How are we living? We happy? We are happy. We need... much less short grass, more soil. Let's get dirty. Just around the edges of the water. Nearly there. There we go. Beautiful. Don't need any... Oh, we do need a little... You'd be surprised how many animals in this game absolutely don't need... like terrain coverage in terms of plant life. Like, so many of them just don't care. I'm going to stick with tropical, because that's kind of the zone that we're in. Nice little I really like coconut palms around the water's edge. I don't know why. I guess that makes sense thematically, doesn't it? Maybe a mangrove tree over there. Some lilies. Yes, I never get to use these ones. I don't think I've ever actually used the Amazon lily pads, so that's very cool. Very sexy. If you find lily pads sexy, then I'm sure you would. These are actually really cool. These are better than the other ones. Because they're big. You know, they're chunky. I like them big. I like them chunky. Sorry. Oh, that's very cool. Very cool. What else have we got? Kapok. I do love a kapok. I don't know if it's over the top. No, kapoks are never over the top. It's impossible for a kapok tree to be over the top. They're the best trees in the game. They actually might be my favourite tree. Now that I think about it. I just wanted to get a little bit of life into the whole park, you know? Like all these areas up here. Just bring it. Yeah, it's just a little bit dead looking. And the idea is we've taken this old abandoned quarry. I think that looks quite nice. We've taken this quarry and we're trying to bring it back to life. We're trying to revitalize it, so we may as well make it look like we actually have done that. Just gonna make this one nice and... Why have you been boxed? For what purpose? Honestly. Are you diseased? No. Now you've just teleported. I don't understand. We need some electricity over here. We need quite a few things still to be done, actually. Birds. Do we have anything? Yeah, we've got a box. feeder. We'll put in a water pipe. It does mean we're not going to have the enrichment I was looking for, unfortunately, but enrichment is actually quite a big problem, generally speaking. Can I just keep putting these in? No. There's a law of diminishing returns there. What about you? What do you do? Yeah, the same thing. Whatever. Sprinkler. Yeah, it's capped out now. Right. Well, we're not done with the nature. Gotta make it pretty. What else have we got? Swiss cheese plants. These are pretty cool. Big fan of those. If there's one thing this lacks, I'd like to like do a little bit of an analysis someday on the different plants available in different areas, just so you can kind of evaluate what's missing and what maybe needs to be looked at. Obviously, some areas, like the Arctic, is never going to be abundant in plants, you know, but... Ooh, you're yellow. Oh, I like that. Maybe like a little thing of them over here. It's a shame there's not more varieties, but... Why not? Yeah, it lacks, oddly enough for a what is essentially a rainforesty kind of environment, it really lacks like ground texture. There's a big lack of bushes and stuff like that. I guess that makes sense, because in a rainforest you don't actually get that many bushes. It's mainly trees and then ground. There's wherever the bush grow, essentially, you know, because it's just massive trees everywhere. But still, I'd like, there's just nothing I can sink into the ground. I can't even make a bush. That's the main issue. I mean, I can kind of use kapox to do it. I don't actually hate how that looks. Is that nuts? Let's bring that in. I really like how, like, having the plant life like sunk under the water. I think that's a really cool look. I'll do it one more time. Maybe one more time. I'd like it. Oh, tamarinds are good, actually. Tamarinds are... Oh, I like tamarinds in general. I'm not going to go overboard with this, I promise. I don't promise anything, actually. I don't want to lie to you. Wimbers! Wimbers are even better than kapox. Let's get rid of the big kapox and let's get a big wimber. Because they're chunky. Look how chunky it is. Bam! It's a beast! I love it. It means that this little guy has to move, though. He's inside the wimber tree, which I'm sure he's enjoying. Yes! Wimber tree! Very cool. Love it. Big fan of the wimbers. There's more wimbers in. A wimber way, a wimber way, a wimber way, a wimber way. I'm not going to sing. It's a terrible idea. In the quarry, the mighty quarry. I put down too many trees. I guess probably too many trees. Right. All we need is like a little staff zone. So what we'll do, what we usually do, we'll hide it in the mountain. Kind of stick to that as a theme as well. Bring that across there. I know, little wimber tree. Don't you worry. We'll look after you in a momento. So, staff facilities. We don't need much. I just need a staff room. Keep a hope, even. Let's get this thing on. Why are you being weird? Oh, that's why. That'll do. And we need some power. And water treatment. Don't I do that every time? Because it does automatically put it in the right way. Oh no, we've got problems. Okay, what's going on with our old carpy? Let's have a little peek at our animal list. We have... I think it's just because we've got two males now, right? So which one's the younger one? You. But that's also incestual. So we're going to release you to the wild, my friend. There you go. We should actually do something for our... Should it play, really? Wait, how's that happened? I've been paused. How has that suddenly popped up? How weird. What's wrong with you? Oh, yeah, that's fine. That's fine. Really, no enrichment at all for the snow leopards? I think there's benefit in maybe slowing down a little bit down the line, making sure each animal has all the enrichment and is just that little bit happier than they are right now. I think we'll focus on that a teeny tiny bit more. No food enrichment. This is my problem. It's always food enrichment. That's the issue, you know, more than anything else. That'll do for now, though. Right. Oh, it's out of range. I'll put something else there. Well, let's have a little look at our props. It has to have something on there. It would look silly not to. What about like a cloth? I know it's African, not Brazilian, but what are you gonna do? I just like how that looks. I mean, that's really cool looking. Again, it's like a slice of life, you know? So, you know, I don't think I need to tell you guys, that's always been a thing for me. Let's put in a little tent as well. The tents are bizarre though, they glow at night, it's really weird. Like, I don't understand why, but they like proper glow. It's pretty cool actually. I'm tempted. It's a tapir though, it's not a bloody zebra. Leave it alone, best in slot. Leave it log! Every good exhibit has a log. Okay, I don't think we're gonna get the panda in this video. I think we'll just work on tidying everything else up, we'll do the tapir, and then we can spend the whole episode making the panda exhibit really nice. I think it looks really cool though. The jeep and the shut up world. I actually really like that. I do have a thing for lily pads. I do have a thing for tents and jeeps, so that's probably partly why. Oh, we need donation bins. Oh, hello. Bloody Nora. Packed down here. Yeah, people are never actually going to go up to where this tapir is. It's one of the major things I'm worried about. It's such a trek to get up here that people don't tend to make that kind of journey. But for the ones out here, give me your money. Release your sweets. Oh yeah, I didn't connect these. I can probably fire some staff as well. I do not need four mechanics, for example. Although they do have, I'll just get rid of one. They do have a high workload, which worries me a little bit. How we doing? Stress is fine. Mechanic research! There we go! So that's ready for the next video. Very cool. Don't know what else to get, really. New world, one of my faves. Vet research! What's this? Buffalo. Okay, Buffalo has enough love. I'm gonna take you off the Okapi and onto the Tapia. Although, underpriced, sweet. Usually similar animals, basically like all ungulates, tend to be able to share, you know, similar things, essentially. Similar enrichment items, that's what I'm looking for. So you only tend to have to research one animal to do it. There we go. That looks a little bit funky. Not in a cool way, not in a best in slot kind of funky way. So I am the king of Funky Town, obviously. I think if there's one word nobody's ever described me as, it's probably funky. I have no discernible sense of rhythm. Which is surprising given how many times I... Actually, no, it's not surprising. I was going to say, given how many instruments I've tried and failed to play, but that kind of might prove the point. Ah, c'est la vie. Right. So yeah, we're just going to focus the rest of the video on making the park look a little bit nicer. So let's get that fixed, and let's get some plant life in here. I want to block off your vision of this area right here. Which means it's tree time. Wimber! I love a Wimber. That's too big. Little baby tamarind. Maybe that tamarind instead. Yeah. Love these as well. Elephant ear plants. One of my favorites. Is that a meme? I feel like that's a meme, but I don't know why. These are huge, actually, aren't they? The lobster claws. You don't really realize until you get up close. They are actually gigantic things. Absolute monsters. I'm sure they don't usually pop out like that, but I do think that looks a little bit better. We do have a little bit of a bush here. It's not my favourite bush in the world, but... You know, to be my favourite bush is a high honour, so it's not really that surprising. What else have we got? There's a slight lack of plant life, oddly enough. Quite like these. Not sure it makes sense to go there, but we'll put it there anyway. Sink that palm in a little bit, get a few more in there. I don't really tend to like having one of something. It has to be like a little group, or there has to be a few of them dotted around. That'll do. It really doesn't need to be a big deal. I just, yeah, want to block it off at least a little bit. This whole area is a bit of a disaster, which is fun. I think we need lights more than anything else. We really need some lighting. Oh, wait, I have bongos? Oh yeah, of course. Shush! God damn! Okay, let's get some lights. What have we got? Yeah, so we've got Asian and we've got African. So we can just use lamppost? Or this one? Which one do we like more? That one or that one? Which one looks more Brazilian? I mean, they're both African themed, but which one looks more Brazilian? I'm leaning towards the left. I think the white pattern... Yeah, I mean, these are smaller anyway. I don't know why that's a good thing, but... Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to turn off a line to surface. I'm going to click them again. And we're going to do that. And this way, they just sit straight instead of bending with the planet. It totally makes sense why they do that, don't get me wrong, it's not what I want right now. Yeah, that'll do. They're a little bit less light than I'd like, potentially, but it's going to look pretty cool. Maybe we could even colour some of them. Can we make them, maybe a slightly more yellow tinge? Is that going to look nice? It maybe would, but I also can't be bothered doing that, 55 times or again, so. I'm just going to shove these in. Shove it in and hope for the best. Best in slots, top tips for planet zoo building and your sex life. Doop, doop. I'm so sorry. I am trying to place these in slightly specific places, either inside people, or indeed I'm just trying not to block, donation bins and stuff like that. Okay, plan, slight cheeky plan. We're going to swap to these ones, and we're going to let these denote, staff areas, you know? I want it to have, a tribal kind of feel. That looks so much nicer already. That's crazy. I actually prefer these ones. The warmer light is a lot nicer. We could change these to be a warmer light, but then you don't have that contrast, which I think is part of what's making that look nicer. So, doomed either way, really. We're doomed. Doomed, I say. Sorry. Some lights in there. Oh, you badly need some lights in here, my friend. There we go. And then back to these bad boys. Oh, no, 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 no. Not quite done with these bad boys. Some over there. Some of these in. I just like lights. They make everything look cool. They really, really do. We need some plant life around here rather desperately. But other than that, feeling good. Just gotta keep rotating. Try not to block anything important. We'll just put it at the same place on each one. That makes sense. Just at the back edge. What are you doing over there, son? What are you playing at? You cheeky little tapir. Someone's actually put in a mod to add the, we've got the beds, but we don't have a Malayan tapir. There is actually a mod out there. Planet Zoo has a modding community. It's a little crazy. It's definitely not as developed as the Jurassic World Evolution one, but it does exist. I'm going to have to put, a little electricity thing over here, aren't I? Yeah. It's only for a little bit, though. It's really annoying. This is why you want your, solar panels and stuff like that, you can make it a lot more subtle that you're adding the electricity in. Whereas now I have to put a massive bloody transformer. Not a cool transformer either. Not a robot in disguise transformer. Game! Don't make it daytime, you're gonna ruin my lovely lighting. I can't tell how pretty things are. I may have gone over the top with the lighting. I will admit. I think on this one, we're going to go play it a little differently. We're just going to have it on the right-hand side. Don't want to spook the snow leopards or some malarkey. I'm sure there's a reason I can make up for why this is a good idea. Oh, the baby! Is that the baby? Where's the baby? Well, that's here, the baby! Oh, look at that! Ah, so cute! I remember desperately trying to get hold of one of these during the Gamescom livestream because I knew this was, we didn't know all the animals at that point. We knew, 30 to 40, if even that. And I know the baby snow leopard was one that people desperately wanted to see, so I spent, all my time just trying to make sure I could breed a baby snow leopard. It was worth it. Okay, I think everything's got lights now. What are we doing? What's going on? What's my challenge? Done that. My yearly profit is miles away. Saying that, A, we don't have the panda. B, I don't have any shops. Maybe we should bring some shops in. I think that'll help a lot. Okay, so sell these. Oh, I just keep hearing the baby. I'm just going to go. We're just going to keep this fairly chill. Can I squeeze two in there? Goal, P. Okay, I have no money. Speed up time. Hopefully make some cashola. Oh my god, yeah, people are thirsty as all hell. I'd like to stick a food shop in there as well. I can do it, I just need funding. You know, you could. Can you take a loan? In, I know this is risky, but can you take a loan? Interesting. In theory, you could take a loan for like the final push. You know, if you had the panda in and all I need to do is get my profit higher, it'd be quite easy to take a loan and then ramp up your education rating and ramp up with your shops and all that kind of jazz. Just something to consider for the future. I'm not going to say I'm doing it now. I do need a bin. I guess we got African. Find a people littering. What's up with you, buddy? Nutrition? Why? What? Oh. Do I only have one keeper? That might be an issue. I got two, but the park is getting a little bit bigger. So yeah, we'll put another one in. I'm sorry, I'll get you sorted. It's my fault. Right, so they're hungry, that'll be fine though. Long cash, that's okay. I think the money is starting to climb a little bit, so let's get a food shop in there as well. Ignore the crazy shops outside. Where was they built? Oh yeah, over here. I figure this is just, there's a lot of through fare over here. People are hanging around here a lot, so. Chief Beef. I am Chief Beef, that was my club name. Okay, that positioning is... I thought that positioning was fine, but it's terrible. Let's bring that back and sink it right down. Is that going to be okay?
Tasty.
So I'm going to... I don't know what's going on anymore. Chief. Hey, it's my fault. Ostrich. What type of ostrich are you? Are you a male ostrich or a female ostrich? You look like a... female, so that should be okay. Ostriches are still one of my favourite animals in this game. I think they're adorable. Maybe less so with the eyelashes. The eyelashes are slightly on the spooky side, but generally speaking, they are super cute. Are we open yet? Where's my bloody staff member? Well, why not? You can't be resting. You've only just been bloody hired. Where are you? You, come here. Diane. Diana Dennison. Hey. This one. Go. Right, she's in. Yeah, the money's actually rolling in really well right now. Funny that, when you give your guests, like, their very basic needs, things go a little bit... Look at them. They're hungry sons of bitches. Oh my god, that's actually nuts. Okay, cool. Nikon message center. Why do I say Nikon? I only say Nikon because other people say Nikon. I don't say Nikon, I say Nikon. I'm sorry. I'm looking for that yearly profit. We've got 9,255... last year. What are we on for this year? This is October. Total profit 6,640. That's bad. But we've bought things. That's kind of the problem. If you buy anything, it comes out your... Because it's not income that we're looking at. It's profit, right? So the second I do anything, I hurt my profit margin. I think next year we'll absolutely smash it. We've made 6K in no time at all. Baby tapirs! I think... So what we should do, actually, is pause... So I'm going to make year 8 the year that I hit that goal, right? And what we'll do is we'll just skip forward through it, and then we'll bring the panda in year 9. Or we could bring the panda in year 8 and then do year 9 for the finance. We'll do that instead. Because what I was thinking is I should do all my foliage and stuff that I want to do right now. Because if you do it now, it'll come out of this year's financial profit. Well, oh, custard apple trees! I forgot about custard apple trees! These are my bushy trees! Yes! if we do it now, it comes out of this year's profit margin rather than next year's, which is obviously a good thing. But the panda exhibit I expect to be quite expensive, so we can only do one or the other, as far as I'm concerned. I'll get some trees and stuff in, make it a little bit more of an interesting area to hang around. Heyo! Guy's having the time of his life. Can't believe I forgot about custard apples. Most delicious sounding tree in the world, and I forgot. Kiss, kiss. There's a lot of lights over here. I need to fix that. Lots to do, lots to do. Oh, not really. Whimber. Is that bad? Okay, the whimber can't block that. Is that fine? I don't mind it going through the trees a little bit. The plants, the thing a little bit. I think that's okay. It looks a little bit weird. That's okay. I'm down for a little bit weird. Let's grab our lights. Where are they? We need some of these. That's a floating rock. That's fine. All the best rocks flow. Everyone knows this. And I need another staff thingamajiggy. There we go. I just hear the baby snow leopard going wah! The big old softy. They are adorable. We'll go spend some time with them in a second. I know we probably don't spend enough time with the animals. I really thought this episode was going to be fairly quick, if I'm honest. And now it's started building and it's like, oh, it's been 30 minutes. I will say the whole park is looking a lot nicer. It comes together now, it all links up. There's trees everywhere. It's really, it feels more like we're bringing it to life, you know, which was very much the intention. So that's cool stuff. Sometimes, it may seem a bit daft, but random placement is actually much better than carefully choosing things. No! No, stop. Stop it. it's just humping the air at this point in time. We're okay. We're low on cash. Mechanic research done. That should be our new world. Don't actually need it at all. Vet research, hoping for something for the tapir. Yes, let's see what we've got. Oh, and the snow leopard gets a blood pumpkin. Very cool. Where are we? There we are. That should help them out a whole bunch, actually. I'll give them a block of ice as well. And the tapir. Species. It's tapir. Barrel of little feeder. That's what we're looking for. There we go. Should have much. Whoops. Many, many more happy animals. How are we doing? 91%. Not bad. The meal quality isn't great, but beyond that, we are feeling good. May have gone overboard on the lights. The more I look at it, the more that looks a little bit nuts. Just gonna decorate a little bit more, but I'm gonna say we are basically done, ladies and gentlemen. So, next video, we'll be bringing Linlin in. Something's going on with Linlin. I don't know why she's having to be smuggled in. Maybe it is, you know, exotic animal trade is very real and potentially harmful things. Maybe that's the idea, and it wouldn't surprise me if Myers was involved in. But at the end of the day, sometimes obviously you can bring exotic animals into a zoo legally, but I suspect that's not what's going on with Myers. So the park is basically done design wise. There's trees everywhere, there's lights everywhere, there's education boards, blah 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 blah. All we really need to do. I wonder what my profit margin was. Did it go up? Got 4,000. This year's not going to be any better, but we will. Oh my god, I'm so poor. There's Linlin. She's a gold star. She's going to make us a lot of money. So, next video, Linlin, giant panda. I'm going to build like a mountain range, maybe, with like some falling water and maybe like a little Asian temple on top. Very cliche panda exhibit, but I'm quite excited to build that kind of thing. That's going to sit right there, and then we will be finished. Look at that. Sexy. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Should add, I said I spent more time with the babies, so I'm going to very quickly do that as well. Because we have a baby. Possibly the cutest baby. I'm very curious what other people think, but this is possibly the cutest baby in the entire game. The baby bird's tapir. It is actually adorable. The bird's tapirs make very cute noises in general. Meow, meow. I really like this exhibit. Where's my baby? My bebe. I want someone to play with the box. I want like a nice thumbnail. Come here. It's so cute! It really is. I don't even know what makes it cute. I mean, all the baby animals are cute. They've all got the big heads and big eyes, or small heads and big eyes. How's that work? I don't know. Big eyes either way, and big heads relative to body size. It just sounds adorable. Right, look, there's a box. I'm living in a box. Doo-doo. Are you adorable? Your eyes are kind of starting to freak me out. I'm not gonna lie. There's evil in those eyes. Vet has not attended Nats. Always looks like there's lots of terrible things going on, but really, there's not. Really, we're pretty okay. Things have turned around. Can I say that? That might be a bit early. Oh god, oh lord, he's coming. He's on the move. Absolutely flying, this little kid. Absolutely flying. There's Papa, or Mama. I think, yeah, it's Mama. Zit, what are you called? Zit Lali, and you're called Zochipili, and Papa is called Kuella. If you don't do it with a little bit of an accent, what are you doing? Although that was not like the correct accent by any stretch of the imagination. Anyway, so we spent some time with the baby. Now we can end things. Again, thank you for joining me. Cheers much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.